Hey everyone, today is going to be a very quick video answering a question which I've gotten by several people lately, and it deals with gradient banding. If you're unfamiliar with banding, it's when a gradient is trying to transition from one color to another, but leaves behind sharp colors of lines. Now let me warn you, you may not see the full result in this video. Because the video is compressed, it may produce banding as well, so make sure you try this out on your own projects or images which may contain gradient banding. Alright, so here I have a blue radial gradient with clear banding. If I zoom in, you can definitely see that the gradient is not completely smooth. Now, there aren't too many ways to deal with banding, unfortunately, but here's a little neat method which I found to work quite well. We're actually going to be using a filter. With the gradient layer selected, head up to Filter, down to Brush Strokes, and then Spatter. Now here we want to make sure that smoothness is all the way at 1, which is probably not what you would think, but trust me, set it at 1, you'll be happy. Then play around with the spray radius until the banding is gone. You may have to look a little bit closer or zoom in a little bit to really see the result. I found that 10 is usually a good value, but it'll depend on your gradients and the size of your image. And just like that, the banding is masked away. It's not completely gone, but it's masked away. Now, if you zoom in a lot, you can probably see the little bit of spatter going on, but at 100%, it looks pretty smooth. Here's the before, and here's the after. Again, before, and after. Now, hopefully you can see the difference in the video, but like I mentioned before, the video is compressed, so that in itself may contain some banding. So you definitely have to go try it out yourself. Trust me, it does work. It's one of the easiest methods to get rid of gradient banding that I've found. But try it out, see how it works. And remember, if you have any Photoshop questions, feel free to email ask@tutcast.com or follow and reply to Iceflow Studios on Twitter. Take care.